Last week, I tried Assetto Corsa Rally in VR on the Pimax Dream Air, and I got blown away. Like, for real. There is no official or native VR support yet, but with the popular and free mod or injector called UEVR or Unreal Engine VR Injector, it works in VR and does feel like a native VR game. And it looks fantastic. Whether you have a Crystal Super, a Crystal Lite, or even the 8KX or previous headsets, you just need to try it. So today I will quickly guide you through the process of getting Assetto Corsa Rally to work in VR, how to change the settings to improve your experience, and lastly, I will give you my first impressions running it on the Dream Air. Before I even get started, I just need to say this. Wow, Assetto Corsa Rally looks incredible in VR. In my opinion, this is the most realistic rally game so far thanks to the Unreal Engine 5 graphical fidelity, and it's maybe the best looking racing game of them all, at least in VR and especially when paired with the micro OLED panels on the Dream Air and the super micro OLED optical engine. This is something you need to try, even if you're not a fan of rally games or racing games in general. Currently, the game is only available on Steam and it's in early access. Right now, it's 20% off on Steam, but you can also get it cheaper as a game key through G2A and similar websites, then activate the game key on Steam. Apart from the game itself, you need UEVR, the Unreal Engine VR Injector by Praydog, that can, often with one click only, turn almost any flat Unreal Engine based game into a fully playable VR experience with stereoscopic 3D view, 6 degree of freedom room scale tracking, and sometimes even full motion controller support. According to many reports in the Flat 2 VR community, the UEVR nightly builds works the best with Assetto Corsa Rally, so I just downloaded the latest version from the Praydog's official GitHub page and extracted the folder on my desktop. So once you have downloaded the UEVR injector, launch it and minimize it for now. Before we do anything else, we first need to launch the Assetto Corsa Rally game from Steam, of course, just like you normally do. Once in the main menu, tap back to the UEVR injector window, and to make sure everything works, especially if you install the game on your C drive, click on the button Restart as Administrator. And as of now, this has to be done every time you launch the game to get it into VR mode. Above the Inject button, click on the drop-down list and pick the running application ACR Assetto Corsa Rally and make sure OpenXR is checked. Once you click Inject, it takes a few seconds and your game pops up in VR ready to go. Essentially, that's all you need to do to run Assetto Corsa Rally in VR. But there are a few things that needs to be tweaked to get a playable experience. I'm not an expert in the racing sims, but let me tell you my approach how to get a rather stable frame rate and a very, very playable experience. Now, this game is quite demanding and will stress the GPU to the max, especially at high resolutions we normally play at with the Pimax headsets, of course. So running it in native resolution at full 90 frames per second on the Crystal Lite, Crystal Super, or the Dream Air headset is basically impossible. At least now in early access, just forget about that, even if you have the RTX 5090. But there are a lot of things you can do to get the smooth rally experience even at native resolution. I haven't done any extensive benchmarks of this yet, but I have been elaborating a little with the Assetto Corsa Rally with my RTX 4090, so I will give you two examples on how you can achieve totally acceptable performance and a rather smooth experience. I think no matter what Pimax headset you got, you should try both methods and see which one you prefer the most. The two methods are lower the refresh rate to 72Hz on the headset and then adjust settings, especially lower the rendered resolution until you reach a frame rate that can mostly keep up 72 frames per second, or run at 90 Hz, enable smart smoothing in Pimax Play, lock the frame rate to 45 frames per second, which is half of 90, and run native or close to a native resolution. I can confirm both these methods work great on an RTX 4090 with the Dream Air DVT sample and also with the Crystal Light, Crystal Super 57 PPD and the Crystal Super Micro OLED. All of these headsets and optical engines utilize a very similar rendered resolution. As for Crystal Super 50 PPD and the Ultra Wide module, these require a much higher rendered resolution, so obviously additional tweaking or a lower in-game resolution will be required to reach similar performance. Before we talk about these two methods more in detail, let's check out the in-game settings first. In the graphical tab of video settings, I disabled motion blur, of course, kept overall sharpness at 100%, and I prefer using DLSS as scaling and anti-aliasing. There are other methods, and some people prefer TSR or even running without any anti-aliasing, but I really, really like DLSS, especially the new DLSS 4 implementation. I set the DLSS resolution scale to 70% and DLSS sharpness at 75%. You may think that 70% resolution scale sounds low, but trust me, it looks really good in this game, especially with the latest DLSS 4. Most other settings here, I left them on a mix between high and medium, with a few exceptions. And honestly, ultra settings won't do that much of a difference, but will tank your frame rate, which obviously we are trying to avoid here. The LCD display quality is set to ultra for a reason, because it's supposed to fix one of the glitches in the game while playing in VR, where LCD is, in certain angles of the view, only seen in one eye. For some reason, ultra setting didn't help me much, and this is still a bug to be fixed. If you know a solution, please let us know in the comments down here below. So, as for in-game settings, without going too deep into it now, I think you can elaborate yourself to find the perfect balance. Now, you saw earlier that we're using OpenXR with UEVR, and you can therefore run any of the OpenXR runtimes available for Pimax headsets, either SteamVR OpenXR or the built-in Pimax OpenXR runtime. Alternatively, you can also run the popular Pimax XR made by Mbucha, which I actually prefer over the others because of slightly better performance overall. If you choose to run the built-in Pimax OpenXR, you can potentially also enable dynamic foveated rendering or fixed foveated rendering through Pimax Play, which can give you a couple of extra frames per second, but it's not a big boost here, and I prefer using Pimax XR runtime, so I didn't bother using any of these. A quick note here. Whatever OpenXR runtime you use, make sure to disable OpenXR Toolkit if you have it installed. For some reason, it kept crashing the game randomly, no matter what OpenXR runtime I tried. Maybe it's already solved by now, maybe you have a fix for it, but at the time of testing, OpenXR Toolkit had to be disabled. Anyway, when attempting to get a mostly smooth frame rate in the 72Hz mode, trying to reach around 72 frames per second without sacrificing too much of the resolution, I ran Pimax Play image quality at 0.7, which is in fact great looking on the Dream Air specifically. We do miss a bit of that extra clarity this way, but in-game DLSS settings and other factors do in fact help a lot to bring back the extra clarity, especially at distance. So 72Hz and 0.7 image quality on an RTX 4090, giving me an in-game rendered resolution of 3490 by 2862 pixels per eye. This way I get a smooth experience most of the time. I still saw some dips down to 68 or even 65 frames per second, but with the Dream Air Micro OLED panels, I really couldn't feel the frame loss. I could of course tweak down this resolution further or lower the in-game settings to always keep a stable 72 frames per second, but I never felt it was necessary. When running 90Hz on the other hand with smart smoothing and the lock to half frame rate setting enabled, I kept Pimax Play image quality at default 1.0, giving me a rendered resolution of 4986 by 4090. This is the native resolution of Dream Air when running the 103 degrees field of view profile with a binocular overlap of above 92%, I think it was. I chose that profile to gain some additional performance, of course, over the 112 degree field of view mode or profile by only losing 9 degrees or so field of view horizontally, which is a fair trade-off if you ask me. Smart smoothing actually works surprisingly well in Assetto Corsa Rally and provides a very smooth experience at 45 frames per second that feels like 90. You probably know this already, but smart smoothing is kind of a Pimax way of frame generation or interpolation. It doubles the frames rendered to match the headset's refresh rate, so it does feel smooth. I didn't see any glitches, only minimal artifacts at the edges of the view and no artifacts at all in the center view. It's surprisingly good looking here. The important thing with smart smoothing is that it always needs some performance overhead available to work as intended. If frame rate dips below 45 frames per second at any point due to GPU not keeping up, you may see some stutters or, worst case, some flickers. So make sure to tweak the game so that your GPU can always keep up at least 50 or let's say 55 frames per second frame rate before you enable smart smoothing and before you lock the frame rate to half. And yes, you need to lock it to half to get it completely smooth this way. With the smart smoothing and native resolution, obviously the game looks a bit more crisp and sharp than it does when running 72Hz and the resolution down to 0.7 in Pimax Play. Native resolution gives you kind of that real Dream Air experience, but it's still not a dramatic difference after all. So make sure to try out both methods and consider which method you prefer the most. Some people are very sensitive to motion reprojection, and in that case, I guess 72Hz mode is a better option. But whatever of the two methods you run, trust me, Assetto Corsa Rally is just incredible in VR. Most of the time, it all looks photorealistic. This immersion is total, believe me, and paired with the Dream Air, I cannot believe it can get much better than this. Colors are amazing, and so is the contrast, of course. Zero pixels to be seen, and the zero aliasing at distance even. Incredible black levels inside the car, and no glare or reflections, even when racing at night. That is all thanks to the micro OLED panels and the new concave view lenses, of course. It's just a freaking crazy VR experience and kind of brings me back to the days when I first tried Dirt Rally in VR on the HTC Vive. Now, here, with today's Unreal Engine 5 and its photorealistic graphics and today's headset, it sets the bar on a whole new level in terms of realism and VR immersion. Having that said, there are still issues and bugs. It's still early access, right? One of them is the LCD panels on the dashboards, which I think should get fixed anytime. Secondly, on default, the brightness or exposure outside of the car is just way too high in VR when sitting inside of the car. This can be fixed by lowering the overall brightness in the video settings slider, but I don't like this method actually, because it makes the game look too dark at times, and especially menus gets dark. It also crushes some blacks. Instead, while running the game, open the UEVR Injector window, check the advanced settings box first, then go to the console variables and use the three sliders R color min, R color mid, and R color max to adjust the gamma and tone mapping. With these values I have here, it looks way better and not as overbright, still keeping proper levels inside the car even when racing at night. So what's more, you can interact with the menus in VR by using the mouse, but the mouse pointer is not aligned to the buttons on default. To kind of fix this, you can elaborate with the UI offset and UI distance and UI size under the runtime tab in UEVR. If you play around with this, move the menu a bit closer to you, then the mouse pointer will perfectly align with all the buttons. Getting the proper seating position in the car can get a little bit tricky doing it the normal way, so I recommend you correct your position and view from here inside UEVR by using the buttons set standard origin and recenter view. So finally, there are many minor tweaks you can do in this game and also in UEVR, but as a last one for this video, if you're sensitive to crashes when racing in VR, or if you get motion sick from a car, from the car constantly jumping around on the track, I mean, after all, this is rally, right? You can lock your VR view to the horizon. I actually don't like this, but I know some people prefer it, especially if you're a beginner or if you're not racing that much in VR. You need to do this after you start up the game, but before you click on the inject button in UEVR, so before you enter VR mode. Scroll down to the game settings in UEVR Injector and find the option VR decoupled pitch, and then enable it, of course. Now click on the inject button to start off the game in VR mode, and now the horizon is kind of like, yeah, aligned to your VR view. Anyway, I apologize for making this video so long, just like always, but I cannot tell you enough how great Assetto Corsa Rally is in VR and how amazing it pairs with the Dream Air and the Super Micro OLED. Performance may still be a bit of an issue, and you need to tweak settings to get it smooth, and there are also some bugs and issues here and there, but overall, already in the early access stage, this is a must-have game and one of the most realistic VR experiences I have had ever. And I've done a lot through the years, I guess. All credits goes to the creators of Assetto Corsa Rally and also Praydog for creating this amazing Unreal Engine VR mod that makes it all possible. So make sure to grab Assetto Corsa Rally from Steam while it's on sale, try it with your Pimax headset, and let us know what you think about it. If you have any tips or hints to share on how to further improve the VR experience and performance in this game, please let us know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.